Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. So in my lecture, you're probably going to notice that I didn't really cover literacy very, very well. I kind of did a little bit, but there was a reason for that. And I'm going to show you this PowerPoint here, and it's actually a little bit more fun than just kind of me lecturing to kind of help us understand what is literacy. Okay, so after this slide number one, we're going to go over to slide number two, if it's going to let me. This one always seems to take a second, so give me 1 second. All right, just has to be prepared. There we go, cool. All right, so I want you to go through and name the theme of the series of photos and videos and GIFs that I'm about to show you. As you see them, try and figure out what in the world could possibly be the ultimate theme of all these things. And no, it's not literacy. You'd think that it might be. But anyway, so let's kind of try and figure out what am I ultimately trying to say here with these GIFs and videos, okay? I highly suggest maybe taking some notes. You can write down on a piece of paper what each picture is, what each GIF is, and what each video is to try and figure out what in the world am I trying to get at, okay? So let's start first here on this slide. We've got, it's a cave dwelling picture. It's actually in France, I forget exactly where, but it's very obviously cave-like. We've got some hand-drawn paintings here. They drew a picture of horses, it looks like, okay, and a bull. We've got some horns. Okay, so, all right, some cave drawings. Next picture. All right, we have Morse code. So if you've never heard of Morse code, it's actually used to be like an old military or telegraph, you know, like a telegraph. I don't know if you guys know what that is, where you tap it and it through the wire makes noises. So something you might have heard for a while. Well, I don't know if you guys ever watch Bugs Bunny anymore. I don't know if it's out there, but SOS was Save Our Ship. It was a very common, what do you call it? Sound. So it'd be like S is da, 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 and then O is da, 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 da. Okay, so that was the way in which you could hear someone asking for help, or it was just kind of type out information based on those sounds. Anyway, that's what this is. Okay, so, all right, take a look and see what could this possibly mean. Next, we have Native Americans. We have one sitting on a horse looking off into the distance and two others. They have a blanket over a fire. And again, it looks like they're attempting something here. Okay, I believe that's called smoke signals. Okay, right. And the next one, we've got sign language here. Okay, sign language giving you the alphabet. If any of you have ever tried, this is actually really fun to learn. Always very helpful. It is a language, very universal. Okay. All right, next. All right, we got a GIF here of Raven Simone. She's looking a little nervous. Okay, just using this GIF to make a statement, I guess. Okay, next. All right, so looks like we've got a little Christopher Walken sitting down on a chair. Let's take a look. Yeah. are. There we go. So we got Christopher Walken showing us his amazing dancing skills. Okay. So next slide, we have what looks like a sign for office dress codes. No halter tops, no jean shorts, no crab hats. Oh, goodness, it's getting weird. All right, so you can tell this is obviously a joke, but probably maybe necessary. Maybe not neckties that say smoke meth. You know, you don't really need to be promoting that. Okay. All right, there we go. Some office dress code signs here. Let's go to the next sign or next slide. All right, so we have some girls who are wearing animal prints, and then next to that, we have some dogs wearing animal clothes. All right, sounds like a statement here. All right, some social media posts here. All right, let's go to the next slide. All right, we have two different protesters, one of which is saying on your left-hand side says, stop premature Christmas decorating. If you work retail, you could probably attest to that statement, okay? And on the left, right-hand side, we have, if God hates gays, why are we so cute? You know, can't argue, all right? So maybe that's a good point. All right, so there we go. We have some protesters. Now, it looks like we've got on this next slide over, it looks like a journal with some handwriting. We've got maybe like a dictionary or an encyclopedia up in the corner, a history book and a map. Looks like maybe the tea and the cactus aren't necessarily what we're looking for here, but you can kind of get a general idea of what we're looking at, okay? Like a journal. I think that's our main point there. Let's see what else we have. Ooh, all right, so if you know me, you don't, but you will. I am a huge Wes Anderson fan. So for that, let's take a look and see what we've got going on here with these movies openings. So there's also some closing scenes. You can always take a look at that a little bit later. All right, so we have some movies. All right, and now to our next slide, it looks like we have some art. And I don't know if you guys know anything about Dolly. This is what we're looking at. This is a very famous painting of melted clocks. All right, so lots of really interesting things going on in this picture. Absolutely very unique. If you ever have a chance to take a better look at it, it's really interesting, especially the eyelashes on whatever that is, the melted clock. All right, cool. Next. All right, looks like we have a lot of very different religious garbs going on. We have, I believe, Hasidic Jews. We have the Pope, who's Catholic. We have some Buddhists. And I believe these, I forget how this was. These guys are actually protesting by wearing what religious leaders would normally wear. And so they're kind of making a statement by wearing the religious attire they're actually not considered supposed to be wearing. Okay, so they're making a statement there. Alrighty, let's go to the next slide. Oh, and here we go. The last but not least, the meme. All right, many of us are very well versed in memes. This is the original beginning of memes. It is the Icon Has Cheeseburger Cat. Okay, so I remember when MySpace first came out, Oh man, memes. They're my favorite. I used to make memes all the time. I am a super nerd, going to admit it. Alright, I worked for a video game magazine. There wasn't much else to do except open mail and make memes. So, anyway, there we go. Okay, so now that we're looking at all these different things... Oh, actually, I lied. A couple more memes. Oh, yay. I totally forgot. Okay, a couple more memes for you because you know what? Memes are fun. I love them. So let's go over here to the left-hand side. It looks like we have a picture of a kid all balled up being bounced by one of his fellow friends. And the statement above says, who remembers? And then below, it says, crack the egg was all fun and games until he got hit with a double bounce and went flying off the trampoline. Incredibly relatable, all right? Or right into the springs. You guys ever do that? Right into the springs that he hit on that metal pole. Super safe. Super safe. Okay. All right. So we have on the right-hand side another meme. Looks like we have a little chunky alien. It says, when your mom's lecturing you on the car ride to school about being more responsible and you're waiting for her to stop talking so you can tell her you left your backpack at home. All right. How many times are you getting lectured in the middle of you doing something like that, right? Okay, let's go to the next set of memes. On the left-hand side, we have someone's statement saying, when Drake said, I'm really too young to be feeling this old, my lower back felt that. Yes. Very much yes. Okay. On your right-hand side, we have another meme. It is a picture of a sign posted to a window, and it says, tag someone who's invited. And the sign says, crying session at my house tonight, 8 p.m. Pull up. All right. So many of you have probably felt this down to your bone, right? Especially the last few months. It is what it is. But yes, there we go. Okay. So next slide, we're going to talk and take a minute and think, what is the main theme of all of these photos, videos, and GIFs? What is it that we are trying to, what was I trying to say here? Okay, so go ahead and you can pause me for a second if you'd like. You can look down at all your little notes and try and figure out what in the world could I possibly have been trying to tell you. All right, let's take one little minute here. And again, you can pause me. Okay, so you are probably looking at this going, this bitch, what is she even doing? All right, some of you are like, psh, I knew it after the first picture, or maybe a few pictures down, okay? Or maybe when you got to the video of Christopher Walken dancing, you were going, what the hell? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the theme here is communication. What? Yes. So, communication, this is all a part of literacy. We are able to understand pretty much what people are trying to say and do just by the ways in which they're acting, right? So what's really cool about the cave dwellings, we go through and we understand that they're trying to tell us something about their past or their potential, their future and our past, right? So they're telling us like, look, this is what we're doing now. Maybe it's just doodles. Maybe there is something ultimately that they're trying to say to us. When it comes to sign language, we're communicating. Morse code, we're trying to tell you something. When we talk about art, art is always trying to say something, even if we don't understand, like what Dolly did. What's going on here? All right, so let me go back to some of those pictures and take a look. Okay, so sorry to rush through that so quickly. Again, sign language, GIFs. How many times and how many have you seen that I've probably posted where a GIF is trying to explain something? I could put this GIF on just about anything, and you can just read her face and understand what I'm trying to say, right? That anxious, what's going on here kind of look, right? When we see Christopher Walken dancing, him sitting down, just his body language alone actually tells us a lot. And then the music starts, and then he starts to dance, and you really start to see a change in his personality or his demeanor, how he's feeling, just by dancing. And the music itself, too, right? The music really kind of leads us to give a feeling. Music is a way of communicating, okay? Obviously, dress codes, when we see signs, signs are always trying to tell us something, whether it's to stop, whether it's to do something, whether it's not to do something. Signs are a way that we can look at it. We see a circle with a red slash in it and go, that means don't do the thing, okay? That is a universal understanding, don't, okay? All right, so some of you were looking at this one and going, what the hell was the point of the girls wearing the animal print and the animals wearing the people print, I guess you would say. Polka dots is a people print? I don't know. Polka dots is Dalmatians. Anyway, when you look at this, when we show off these pictures to our friends and our family, we're communicating, look, look at me. I feel good. I want to show you. Or look at what I've done. Or look at what I'm doing. It's a way of communicating your experience. And a lot of times below, you might have, you know, a lot of dialogue underneath to either explain the photo, like finally reunited with my sisters, I guess, right? So just different ways in which we kind of communicate. Hey, look at my cute little doggies. They got little rain gear on. This is fashion. Okay? Again, when we talk about protesting, absolutely communicating with signs, letting you know it's too soon for Christmas, that kind of stuff. Okay. All right. We communicate through writing. We communicate through reading. When we read something and then we utilize that, that is what we're going to be doing in class, taking information and using it. Okay. That's definitely our research. Okay. Movies, absolutely. Are something that communicate a point. Sometimes it's just for, you know, emotional effect. You know, when we watch the things that are exploding or scaring us, sometimes there's a point behind it. I really love Wes Anderson. Again, if you haven't watched any of them, they're all really good, except for Bottle Rocket. It's okay, but it's Wes Anderson, so it still can be darn good. Okay? All right, and again, Dolly's art. And religion, religious attire, every single one of these people is making a statement. They're communicating with you based on what they're wearing. They're telling you, look, I'm a man of the cloth. I am a religious this, I'm a religious that. Or we're making a statement, we're not, but we're going to tell you that your attire is, you know, I don't know, dominant. I don't know, I can't remember what the guys were we're protesting. I gotta look that up again. Anyway, so again, religious attire, they're communicating with us something about who they are, about what they stand for, about how they believe. Okay? All right. And then memes. Ladies and gentlemen, memes are hands down some of my favorite things, and mostly because we're communicating in ways like this. Every single one of these, at some point, someone in one of my classes has looked at it and been like, yep, I know that feeling. I totally get that. Okay, or, you know, the next meme's over with the Drake statement or the wanting to cry. Okay, so the reason why I love memes so much is they are a great way to communicate. Let's see, let's go through. The reason why, so with memes, the reason why I like doing this particular lesson plan, we're going to do it a little different online, is sometimes we have to explain the meme. All right, and I'm going to show you that. So kind of like what we talked before with the bonnet, where you could just see a bunch of letters. And, sorry, the bonnet was the Bonnet Chronicles. It was the meme with all the different letters. And each letter represented a word, and we knew what it meant. How did we know that? How did we know each letter meant something? It meant it stood for a word, and we knew that based on the order of the letters, okay? So here we're looking at this as, yeah, if you could go ahead and explain memes, that'd be great. I can't tell you how many times I've been on like Instagram and someone posted a meme. I'm like, what the fuck does that even mean? And I go through and I research it and I'm like, oh, I'm going to give you an example. So first of all, a meme is an infinite number of permutations of different phrases and images, sounds, and videos that spread out through either the internet or just different ways to where we can be very succinct, say all the things we want to say with that particular picture. One of which is this gentleman with the next slide over. So an example is, why should we hire you? And this gentleman's laughing. You might be looking at that going, I don't get that. That's not funny to me. When I first saw this, I was like, damn it. I don't know what this means, but I'm going to find out. So I went ahead and I did a little research. And then I remembered, oh, the Fyre Festival. Well, this guy is a part of the documentary of the Fyre Festival. And I'm going to kind of give you a little rundown. So let's go to the next slide here. This gentleman is Andy King, and he was a Fyre Festival employee. And he confessed in an interview for the Fyre Festival documentary that he drove across the island with the full intent of, how do I say this? Doing whatever it took. I'm going to put that in quotes over here. Do whatever it took to get bottles at Evian. For the from a customs agent, right? So if you guys don't know what the Fire Festival is, let's go a little further and get deeper to try and understand what the hell's going on here. Okay, so the Fire Festival was a failed luxury music festival. It was founded by Billy McFarland, so you can try and figure out who Billy McFarland is. We'll get there later. It was founded by Billy McFarland that was set to take place in the town of Exuma of the Bahamas. Like, okay, so there was this festival in the Bahamas. Who the hell is Billy McFarland? Here we go. Okay, do you see how you start getting really deep when it comes to trying to understand memes? Billy McFarland was the founder of a company that marketed an invitation-only charge card called Magnesis, I think it was, as well as developing the Fire mobile app, which was used for booking music talent. Okay, see where he's going here. So the point of the Fire Festival was to promote the Fire app. But, and again, so that was including musical talent, so there's going to be a lot of people, very quote-unquote famous people who are supposed to be at this festival. The point of the Fire Festival is to promote the Fire app, but after attendees had arrived, it was aborted due to lack of food, logistics, talent, and security, among other things. In other words, people showed up, and it was a shit show. And the kind of people who could afford said festival were incredibly, like, wealthy and pampered and, you know what I mean? Like, they were expecting luxury. And instead, I think at the most, they got a couple of tents and a few snacks. At the most. Okay? So, now, Billy McFarland is considered a convicted fraudster. Okay? So, the meme, as you go back, you're like, wow. So, this guy, this Andy King, we're going to go back to Andy King. This guy was one of the employees, and you can imagine if you've ever worked retail for entitled people, and they come in and they're screaming, they're fighting, and they're yelling, you're doing everything you can, it's still not enough. He was probably really getting some heat, so he was desperate. Desperate to keep his job, desperate from, I don't know, being torn apart. Who knows what was going to happen for him. So he goes all the way across the island, and he's begging the customs agent for just some Evian water, right? So... anyway, so the joke is, why should we hire you, Andy? And he laughs, because Andy would do anything for you. Hint, hint. Alrighty. Alright, so we're going to go back. The purpose of all of this is communication is a huge part of existence for human beings. It can be done through art, through music, symbols, clothes, words, videos, everything. Okay? Memes act as a meshing of many of those aspects of culture. Okay? They become a link to understanding humanness. The thing I love about memes is sometimes they'll post something, well, damn, yeah, I totally feel that. And you feel connected. You feel a part of. You feel understood. We relate through memes, and we connect through memes, and we become a part of through them. You don't feel so alone when there's certain memes that relate to you, okay? That being the case, feel free to, when you go to introduce yourself, when you go to... you already done the introducing things. Sorry, forget what week I'm in here. When you go through and you put your memes in for the discussion, you can put memes, you can put videos, you can throw in these different ways of communicating. I am absolutely okay with that. I love it. Be creative, be fun, make it your own. If you don't know how to do that, you can ask me. Maybe I can guide you through. You can fart around and figure it out, whatever you want to do. This class, I want you to do, you know, go ahead and have fun and understand, you know, literacy. Again, literacy, say you don't know how to post a GIF or a meme or a picture. This is how you kind of learn. We talked about growth and fixed mindset. Fixed mindset, be like, I don't know how to do this. And you could just forget it. Or maybe you just don't want to. That's fine too. But maybe you kind of do deep down want to do it. And you kind of also want to throw a fit because you don't know how to do it. Go on Canvas, mess around. There's a little icon that shows you how to insert an image. In fact, I can show you that too. I'm not on there. Darn it. Anyway, so what we can do is, let's see if there's any more going on here with this. Okay, so anyway, you could go on, you can post things if you want. Again, question for you, we talk about literacy. Can you be literate or illiterate in memes? So can you be literate or illiterate in memes? Yeah, of course, you can be illiterate and literate in just about anything, okay? Some of you might be like, I don't know who Wes Anderson or Christopher Walken is. Like, this stuff doesn't mean anything to me. And that's okay. That's just a different, you know, for me, that's what I know. Maybe that's not what you know, but now you know because I shared it with you. Okay, so anyway, go ahead and post some of your discussion. You can talk about literacy in any way, shape, or form. And let me know if you have any questions, and I look forward to your responses.